not easy to be understood in these days, the carriage dashed through the streets and swept around the corner. Was almost screaming before it, and men clutching each other and clutching children out of the way. At last, swooping around the street corner by a fountain, one of my wheels came to a sickening little jolt, and there was a loud cry from the voices, and the horses reared and turned. But for the lack of inconvenience, the carriage probably would not have stopped. Carriages often know to drive on and leave their owners behind, and why not? But the frightened valet had got on in a hurry, and there were 20 hands to a horse's rider. What has gone wrong? Said the steward, coming looking out. A tall man in a nightcap had caught up a bundle from among the feet of the horse, and had laid it on the basin of the fountain, and was down in the mud and wet, howling over it like a wild animal. Pardon, Monsieur the Marquis, said the ragged